Charles Delcerati. From Chicks, Breanne Leary. From The Price is Right, Bob Barker. And George Dillabon. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn!
Okay, John, everybody ready out there? Thank you for joining us here. Come and meet all the folks.
Hi, Clay.
Nice to see all of you again. And it seems only yesterday that I...
Been a long time, Dean?
Yes, very long. Be careful. This lady was a contestant. She sat over there. How long ago was that?
Oh, gee, about 2 years ago?
Yes, it was, right. And you won some loot?
Yeah.
And she said at the time during the interview that she wanted to get into the show business. And she did. She's on Chips.
Chips, yes.
After my last visit with you, it was suggested that I might do better over there.
Oh, yeah.
No, the producer was the one who suggested that.
Ira Scott said that to you?
Mr. Scott.
No, he was only
joshing. I call him Mr. Scott.
You do, really? Yeah. I
think you should do that one more time.
Yeah. May I have some, please?
Yes, of course.
Really embarrassing. Okay.
No. Well, we have to give her a proper welcome now. This is her first time over here as a celebrity.
Yeah,
welcome, Breanne. Okay, let's say hello to Burt Waring and Kathy Kelleher over here. Ladies, nice to see you once again. Burt Waring is the current champ with $10,600. And she's very happy about that. Now, we're in the middle of round one. Kathy, you've had your question. You match two of our stars. And we'll pick up with Burt here and see how this goes. Right now, I guess we're going to do that, right? Okay, here we go. Burt, your first round question reads as follows. Rita said, last night, I was invited to a party for doctors only. It was strange. They served the wine in a blank. Okay. Here we go. Almost. Now we're ready. Rita said last night I was invited to a party for doctors only. It was strange. They served the wine in a blank.
Syringe.
Like in a syringe.
Shot syringe.
One of those big syringes. Okay. That's a possibility.
Yeah, it's a strange answer, but, see, my problem is I have a very long nose, Gene.
And you have a long nose?
Have you noticed?
No, I haven't noticed.
The problem is I got fixated on it here and I said beaker.
Beaker. You took chemistry in high school.
What could I do?
Yeah.
It was a required course.
All right.
I didn't take chemistry, and I didn't say syringe. I said they served it in a bedpan.
Yeah.
That's
when she was a kid, she played doctor and nurse. That's how she got that answer. What
mostly
do you say?
Mostly I got to do the nurse.
Specimen cup.
Specimen cup. Oh, this is really a revolting show.
Question. It's a revolting question.
Aren't you glad you showed up here today?
Oh, yeah. I matched Brett. As a matter of fact, bedpan.
You said bedpan.
Yes.
Okay.
She matched me when she was a contestant for
$5,000.
What do you think of that?
Are you going to give that money back now?
Yeah. The government has
it. With the interest.
And he's at Harvard now.
Okay. Glad that his doctors only was strange. They served the wine in a...
Before I reveal this answer, I today do not intend to allow the audience to intimidate me.
No. I don't even know if they're alive.
And the moaning, I am not going to be intimidated.
Okay.
How about the other contestants?
But you will be nice to me.
Yeah. Right.
I said hot water bottle.
Hot water bottle.
All right,
now, that's it. Now, wait a minute. Be nice to him. That's not a bad answer. I find it quite amusing myself. It's like those, the mountaineer people who drink the wine out of that. What do they call that? No, it's a calfskin bag.
Over the shoulder.
Right.
Exactly.
Right. What?
Funny you should mention that.
That's what you have on your card.
Well, sort of. Well, I thought it was maybe some pathologist involved, so I said in a bladder.
In a bladder.
That
doesn't even make any sense.
It does, too. It's like one of those things.
Aren't you glad you came? Okay, there's the end of round one. 2-0 the score. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Right now, this for you.
It's a new day.
Good to have you here.
With a new lineup. It's Buzzr's Morning Eye Opener, featuring some of your favorite shows, plus the new game, Split Second with Monty Hall.
Are you ready?
Set your alarm, starting tomorrow morning at 8. Slotomania believes...
I'll pick A for Amy.
A for who?
Amy.
Amy.
My daughter.
That's your daughter.
Once in love.
You may not believe this, but Fat Frida can touch her toes. Isn't that amazing? Not with her hands, with her blank. You don't play, and you don't play. Kathy, you ready? Okay, here we go. You may not believe this, but
Wait a minute, Mr. Riley. Surprisingly enough, has not finished.
Okay. Now, Fat Frida can touch her toes, not with her hands, with her blank.
Her boobs.
Her boobs. What you call your basic super droopers. Yes.
That's the gene we've learned.
Just putting out my rubber chain, Gene. You can intimidate Bob Barker from all sides.
Okay. Fat Frida can touch your toes, not with her hands, with her...
But with her belly.
Belly, okay. She said boobs. What do
Too
you say?
Too bad.
Here?
She was right.
I say, you bend over and touch your toes, and I'll show you where the wild goose goes. I said chins.
Chins. We're getting everything but the upper frontals here, Charles.
I said because I'm trying to bring class to the game. You know, with what, a four-letter word starting and ending with B and having two vowel O's in the middle.
Okay.
That's it. Let's figure it out.
One for Kathy. Here's your three all together. Okay, Joyce, show us yours. Close enough.
I was trying to bring a little class, too, but I didn't need all that explanation. I just said her bosoms.
Bosoms, all right. Four for Kathy. Now, Bert, since it's round two, the final round, you need 4 to tie, 5 to win. Jim the junk dealer is a junk dealer through and through. Even his blank is a wreck. Jim the junk dealer is a junk dealer through and through. Even his blank is a wreck. Okay.
He's just doing what we call variation.
Jim the junk dealer is a junk dealer through and through. Even his blank is a wreck.
His wife.
His wife is a wreck. Even his wife is a wreck. Now, you don't have to give us that polite applause just because you think, I mean, if it's because it's obligatory, am I? I mean, if you don't like the answer, just cool it. I know booze or anything like that, but, you know, just, yes.
I know Jim the junk dealer. He's the guy who sold me my rubber chain.
That's
and
right.
And I know for a fact that his wife is a wreck.
Okay. Got it on the score? Yes.
From that famous game show, Bite Your Wife.
Bite Your Wife? What did you score?
Well, he might have been a junk dealer, but he had a full day. I said wife, mistress, and secretary.
All of them. 4-3 to score. Brianne?
They both look so lovely. They look like little Christmas trees. They're red and green. Anyway, wife.
You got wife, too. Tie score. One more wrecked wife will win the game.
I have won.
Kathy, it was a pleasure to meet you. I'm going to send some gift your way from Match Game 79. Kathy Kelleher, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for being with us.
Bye.
Here we go. We're going to spin a commercial or two, and then you come back and see how much money she wins. Okay? Just one second here. There's a very sweet lady in our audience here today. Her name is Fanny Goodson. She is the mother of Mark Goodson. And tomorrow... Whoops, I walked right in front of your shot, didn't I? Gee, I shouldn't have done that, should I? Holy mackerel. Gosh darn it, I walked in front of that shot, didn't I? Anyway, tomorrow she is going to be 92 years old, and I want to say happy birthday to her. Hello, Fanny. She's a good kisser, too.
Charlotte, you have to know Charlotte.
You're feeling okay?
Fine, just fine.
Good. It's wonderful to have you here, and many happy returns of the day. Fanny Goodson. Oops, I walked in front of the shot again. All right. Now we're going to have a go here with Bert Waring. She's got $10,700, and we'll see how much more she'll win. As we come here to this super match, we polled a studio audience not too long ago, Bert, and said, write down your best answer to this. The happy blank. $500 for matching their most popular answer, and for matching the second most popular, $250, and for matching the third, $100. Now, whom do you call on for a little assist here?
Brett. Happy days.
Happy days.
Our hero again.
The happy days.
Watch it.
All right, that's hers.
Charles?
The happy hooker.
Yeah. Why didn't you do it like that? Bob?
Bob, have you got one? Third is tough.
Oh, you would come to me now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, now think about it for a second. Something may come to you.
The happy hooker was the only thing
Here's
I could
Here's a good
think.
One.
Excuse me. Here's a good one.
Yes.
The happy hour.
Yeah. The happy hour.
The happy hour.
So you have the happy hour, the happy hooker, and the happy days. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I wish I was at the happy hour, but I'm going to go with the happy hooker.
She's going to go with the happy hooker.
I don't.
Don't go with her.
I hope you'll be very happy together.
No, don't go with her.
Okay.
You can say it for the answer, but don't go with her.
No, it's the happy hooker that she's chosen there, the one that Charles gave. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll reveal the $100 number, if you please. The happy hour. Okay.
Hey.
That was Bob's answer. May we see, with a little assist there from someone.
No, that was my own idea. It just came to me, though, after I read it on another card.
Sure. May we see the next one, please? The happy day. Well, yeah, it was up there. That's surprising.
Nice.
Very good, Brad. Okay, last chance for the happy hooker. Go! Yeah! Very good. Now, Bert, you've picked up another $500. You've gone over the $11,000 mark. You have $11,200. More important than that, you're going to play for 10 times the amount of money you just won. That's a minimum you'll play for, $5,000. But a lucky spin of the star wheel will double your money. You'll play for $10,000. Will she double it or not? Let's find out right now. Go! All right. Double your money. Close. But you almost rooted it home there. Brett, you ready? Playing for $5,000. Good luck to Bert Waring. Here it is. Barrel of blank. Barrel of blank.
Okay.
Okay. Now, Bert, give us the answer that she's got on the card. If you do that, you get $5,000 additional. You'll be up to $16,200. What do you say?
Barrel of monkeys.
Barrel of monkeys. Okay.
I'm so PO'd. I threw it away. I wrote down three. I'm so mad. I said fun. I'm so furious. I wrote down monkeys, laughs, and fun, and went eating.
Barrel of laughs, barrel of monkeys, and barrel of fun, and you threw away the monkeys and kept the fun. Well, I don't blame you for that.
That's showbiz.
That's right.
Showbiz. That's showbiz.
You win some, you lose some, Bert. That's the way it is. Here we go now. Let's meet another competitor. Here comes Stacy Ziegler. Hello, Stacy.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
We welcome you. And before we start the game, we'd like to find out who you are, where you're from, anything you want to tell us about you.
Okay. Born and raised in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Work for an orthodontist in Tarzana. I have a 4-year-old daughter.
Yeah.
And I like to water ski, play a little racquetball.
Yeah.
That's about it.
You didn't say you have pretty brown eyes.
Oh.
I'll say that.
Thank
she has
you.
Pretty brown eyes. Yes.
Thank you.
And a nice smile. Nice dimples, too. And we wish her the best of luck as we go here to round one and ask her to choose A or B.
A.
A it is for Stacy Ziegler. The doctor said.
Yes.
Big on doctors.
Doctor said I have a very strange patient. He's been kept alive by a machine. Well, what's strange is it's a blank machine. Strange patient being kept alive by a machine. And what's strange is it's a blank machine.
Ask the old man if I need braces. Do me a favor.
Okay.
Thanks.
He doesn't need other doctor, does he? The doctor said I have a very strange patient. He's being kept alive by a machine. What's strange is it's a blank machine.
One of those machines that tunes cars.
One of the machines that tunes cars? An engine analyzer?
Yeah.
Engine analyzer.
A car tuning machine.
I don't know.
I'll give you odds on that one.
A tuning machine.
A tuning machine.
Yeah. That's I didn't say that, however. I said a sewing machine.
A sewing machine? That's a good one. What do you got?
It's a machine, anyway.
Right.
With this ditzy group up here, she thinks we're going to be smart enough to say engine analyzer?
No.
Heavens, no. I said a washing machine.
Well, certainly. It's simple, straightforward. Don't give complicated answers here, Stacy.
I never say anything I couldn't spell.
I said the same thing as my cute buttercup said.
He's changing his tune there. When he steals an answer, he's all smiles and friendly.
Sure. I was going to say engine analyzer. I said it last week for two questions. Okay. I want to use it again.
Sure. Okay, Brianne, what do you got there?
He's a very clean person, washing machine.
Washing machine seems like a good answer to me, Stacy. What do you got, Bob?
I have a very scientific answer. It's straightforward, as you suggested, but it's scientific. Now, if you are going to live longer, you're going to have more years, right? Therefore, you're kept alive by an adding machine.
An adding machine.
I think that this audience and I are operating on a higher intellectual level than the rest
of you. That's right. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's nice to play to a bunch of Zen Buddhists. I've never done that before. Okay, Joyce.
Yes.
You're up.
Oh, yes, that has to do with my answer.
That's right. He's being kept alive by a machine. What's strange is it's a...
ball machine.
A what?
Ball? You know, they throw...
Oh, the ones that throw the tennis balls and baseballs, the ball machine.
Well, that's
going to
keep you alive. Got to be on your toes.
That's right. How come nobody said a Cuisinart or anything like that? Those are machines there.
Couldn't spell it.
Couldn't spell that, huh? Okay. Now, you stand by for your round one question. Right now, we have a little message for you. Thank you.
This is not a radish, as I thought it was. It looks very much like my car. You can tell with the little lipstick. We're taking liberties, obviously.
Alexplanations with Alex Trebek. Classic concentration. Weekdays at 1.
Hi, I'm...
What?
I thought the show was over, and he was just showing me what a snap is.
We were comparing shoes.
I was showing him mine, you see.
Yes,
of course.
And he was showing me
And I was showing
his.
Us.
All right. We'll now get a preference there. If you... All those who like these shoes, please applaud. Okay. All those who like these shoes, please applaud. The winner.
They were not applauding for the shoes, they were applauding for the legs.
Oh, no, you got nice legs there.
Here I was robbed.
Yeah, let go of my cord there. Are you ready for this? Tough Teddy said, I'm really tough. Last week, I entered the demolition derby. Everyone else used a car. I used my blank.
Demolition Derby.
Everyone else used a car.
Is that where everything
But I used my blank.
Everything.
They have a bunch of cars in this big ring, and they keep hitting each other, and the last car that survives is the winner. They smash each other, you see, and try to incapacitate one another's automobiles. And
the survivor
is the winner. Okay, here we go with Bert Ware. Tough Teddy said, I'm really tough. Last week I entered the demolition derby, and everyone else used a car, but I used my...
Mother-in-law.
Very good. What do you got there?
Not mother-in-law. I used my head.
Head is a good one.
I thought you had to be behind a vehicle.
No?
Not necessarily.
Oh, just show the car.
Sorry. I said bicycle. I thought it
that's
was...
That's all right. No, that's okay. Bicycle is all right. Oh.
I said motorbike, Jake.
Motorbike is okay also. Head, all three are good answers there. And you, Brianne, what have you got? Head.
I too thought that you had to have a vehicle, but I also thought it would be good if you were not in any way protected. It's another scientific answer, skateboard.
Skateboard is good. No, nothing wrong with that. We wouldn't knock that for a minute, would we?
Not, no.
No.
She can't afford to.
I said had to use it. He used a scooter.
A scooter. All good answers. Yours is good, but no match. Now, no score here at the end of round one. Stand by for round two, but first this for you.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 79. And Bill Chapman production. This program is edited for broadcast.